Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijja, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity, Sikhism, and real Islam, which is different from what these Mohammedans are doing. So in the previous video, I described how Christ Jesus was acting both as the Son of, anointed Son of God, who represented God, and also the anointed daughter of God that was preaching us the gospel in the name of our Mother Holy Spirit. Remember, the God is male and Holy Spirit is the female, and they are both in the same entity, that means in the same person. So Holy Spirit is also called the tongue, the mouth, you know, mouthpiece of God. So you can imagine what is the relationship between God and Holy Spirit. So Holy Spirit is just the what comes out of the mouth of God is represented by Holy Spirit. And that is our food, which she gives us and feeds us on gospel truth. That is our food. So Christ Jesus, after preaching gospel to the 12 laborers, out of which one Judas Iscariot was not properly dressed, or he was loving Mammon than God, he was thrown out. So the 11 were taken into the bridal chamber, which was the Eucharist of Sacrifice. So Eucharist of Sacrifice everybody knows, but they have changed it to, in some countries like UK, United Kingdom, into the Eucharist of Remembrance, that they take that Eucharist once a week in the remembrance of our brother, anointed brother Christ Jesus. In fact, Eucharist is the baptism of our anointed elder brother in Holy Spirit and God. So as you take the baptism of John in water once, and not in babies, not like they're doing it to the babies and all that nonsense. You take the baptism of John the Baptist in water once, and this baptism of Christ Jesus is to be also taken once. Not that you keep on repeating every week. And repeating every week means mockery of our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus. So in this one, the Christ Jesus, he is the Son of God. His marriage was celebrated through Eucharist, in which he married the younger daughter of Holy Spirit. Remember, Jesus was the daughter of Holy Spirit with capital D, and we are daughters of Holy Spirit with small d. So it was the marriage of sealing the covenant of the workers in the service of God. That is called Eucharist of Sacrifice. That you are sacrificing your physical word or physical attachments, such as family, home, land, property, everything, you know, which you have, for the sake of Christ Jesus in the service. So when you married Christ Jesus, the Son, by taking the Eucharist of Sacrifice, then you have forgiven, or you have forsaken your properties. You remember, Jesus was neither a hireling, and nor those people who take Eucharist. After that, they don't work for money. but they work for God. So John, remember that Paul, when he was making tents, he was not a parasite of society. If you, after the Eucharist, if you don't want to work, that doesn't mean that you should be a parasite on the people, that they should bring you the food and you should eat it, you know, without any conscience. So the gospel is preached without any obligation. So you don't take any obligation. Even the food offered to you is an obligation, that you have received the food as part of the wage for preaching the gospel, which is wrong. So that's why St. Paul, he was working in his trade so that he can earn money and he can buy his own food and eat it and not be a parasite on anyone. So when he was making these tents, he used to buy the material and make the tent. He would not ask the price. He would let the customer pay whatever pleased him, whatever his conscience allowed. So in case some customer was happy and paid him much more than the what he was expecting or what he has spent on, then he, after considering that, oh, this will be enough, you know, as a profit, what was overpaid, he would return it back to him. He would say, no, this is too much, you know, this is enough. So this is how they do this, do their work for living. So they do not ask for mammon. Whatever the person pays, he would normally pay reasonable, that will cover his expenses. So they were not there to make business out of what they were doing, but just to sustain themselves that they were working. So they, nobody has any obligation that, oh, I fed him and what he did for me and all that, you know. It is God who does the thing. We are just a workers of God. We work for our Father. We don't bestow. The grace is of our Father, not our grace. So whatever pleases God, he will give you, and whatever pleases God, he gives us. You know, we don't ask our Father, give us this, give us that. Whatever he pleases, we accept it. So many people think, you know, that, oh, let's pray, we asking from God, give us this and that, which is a wrong doing, which is wrong thinking. God knows the matters of your hearts. You don't need to pray. And he knows what you want. He will give you. So why ask him? He's caring. He's not the one who would not care for you. So you just do the job and leave it up to him. Now, in the next video, I was going to describe the role played by the other two prophets. Remember, I told you that two prophets came in the Middle East and two appeared in the East. So in the next video, I will describe their part. And the two prophets that appeared in the Middle East, they were John the Baptist, an ideal Levite priest, a rabbi, a prophet Elijah, and Christ Jesus. Christ is the royal priest of God, who came to preach the gospel, who came to sow the seed of the gospel, so that this is the age of gospel, and no more of letters or works. Gospel come, you receive through revelations, and not by reading books.